Yeah, for glad. Well, today we have the special joy of baptizing Travis and Brittany Petro's daughter, Sawyer. Hear the words of our Lord as recorded in Matthew chapter 28. Jesus said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all of the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe everything that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, even to the end of the ages." Here also God's word is recorded in Acts chapter 2, verse 39. "The promise is to you and to your children, and to all that are far off, everyone whom the Lord our God calls." Obeying the word of our Lord Jesus and confident of his promises, we baptize those whom he has called. In baptism, God claims us and puts a sign on us to show that we belong to God. God frees us from sin and death, uniting us with Jesus Christ in his death and resurrection. By the water and the Holy Spirit, we are made members of the church, the body of Christ, and we are joined to Christ's ministry of love and peace and justice. Let us remember and let us rejoice in our own baptism as we celebrate this sacrament this morning.
On behalf of the session of this church, I present Sawyer Ann Petro to receive the sacrament of baptism.
Brittany and Travis, who is your Lord and Savior? And do you intend to be his faithful disciple, obeying his word and showing his love to your life's end? If so, say, "I do." And do you intend Sawyer to be his disciple, to obey his word and to show his love? The tradition of baptismal sponsors, traditionally known as godparents, is a long and an honorable one. Sponsors, along with the parents, and indeed the whole of the church, are responsible for the spiritual nurture of the child in the Christian faith. To be an effective sponsor, a person above all must be on the road of discipleship, him or herself. Brittany Travis have asked Chris and Taylor Simmons to be Sawyer's sponsors, and so we have a few short questions for them also. Who is your Lord and Savior? And do you intend to be his faithful disciple, obeying his word and showing his love to your life's end? If so, say, "I do." And lastly, do you promise through prayer and example to support and to encourage Sawyer to be a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ? If so, say, "I do." Welcome. Through baptism, we enter the covenant that God has established. Within that covenant, we are given new life and we are guarded from evil, nurtured by the love of God and God's people. On our part, we are to turn from evil and towards God in Jesus Christ. I ask you, therefore, to reject sin and to profess your faith in Jesus Christ and to confess the faith of the church, which is the faith in which we baptize this morning. With the whole church, then, throughout the ages, I would invite you to stand as we confess our sin, as we confess our faith, rather. Do you believe in God the Father Almighty?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We give you thanks, O holy and gracious God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the water, and you created all that is seen and unseen. By the gift of water you sustain all life. In the time of Noah, you destroyed evil with the water of the flood, and by your saving ark, you gave a new beginning. You led Israel through the sea out of slavery into the freedom of the promised land. In the water of Jordan, our Lord was baptized by John and anointed by your Spirit. By the baptism of his death and resurrection, Christ set us free from sin and death and opened the way into eternal life. We thank you, O God our Father, for the gift of baptism. In this water, we are buried with Christ and his death. And from this water, we are raised in his resurrection, reborn by the power of the Holy Spirit. By the power of your Spirit, O Lord, bless this water, that it may be a fountain of deliverance and rebirth. Wash away the sins of all who are cleansed by it. Raise them to new life and wrap them in the body of Christ. Pour out your Holy Spirit upon them, that they may have power to do your will and continue forever in the risen life of Christ, to whom, with the Father and the Holy Spirit, be all glory, now and forever. What Christian name would you have your daughter back on? Sawyer Ann, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Gracious God, what a joy it is this morning to receive this small child into the body of Christ. What a blessing she is and what a future she has ahead of her, full of challenges and joy and adventure and sorrow. And someday, O Lord, this child will depart from this earth. But Lord, we thank you that this morning you promise that you shall never leave her nor forsake her, but that you shall always walk with her through every step of her life and even to her dying. We ask, O Lord, that you might implant within her the gift of faith, that she might grow to be a woman of stature and maturity in your word, that she might serve you in word and in deed all of the days of her life. Pray this in the precious name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, to the glory of the Father. See what love the Father has for us, that we are called the children of God, and indeed so we are.
Baptism, God has made her a member of the household of God to share with us in the priesthood of Christ. I charge you, the people of St. Paul Presbyterian Church, to tell this new disciple the good news of the gospel, to help her know all that Christ commands, and by her fellowship to strengthen her family ties with the household of God. Please join me then in our unison prayer of welcome and discipleship.
O God, our Father, we praise you for calling us to be a servant people and for gathering us into the body of Christ. We thank you for choosing to add to our family of faith. With joy and thanksgiving, we welcome Sawyer into Christ's church, for we are all one in Christ. We promise to love, encourage, and support her, to share the
You may be seated.
Paul,